communication as Mercury is all about. Service here is also in physical form rather than what, you know, not going and helping others, but inventing something that would help everybody. Okay. So guardians of the unprotected is another thing that they show love and care and affection for those who are lacking in some manner, and they tend to take them under their wings. They're also said to be very friendly to elderly women who are unmarried. So those women, if you call upon, like I said, if you call upon Ashwini Kumars, if you're traveling and you have a problem, then you call upon Ashwini Kumars, they come to your help. He has a generous nature. We'll talk about William Kolff. He is a Dutch-American physician and inventor, a pioneer in hemodialysis and development of artificial organs. You know, one of the few people you would fall in love with just reading about him on Wikipedia. Trust me, he's done so much that one wouldn't think that it is capable within human boundaries. And yet, he's not patented even one of his groundbreaking inventions. And he's had a real good life. Saturn sitting there in his Ashwini Nakshatra. And Saturn is the lord of the seventh house of secondary profession, eighth house of death, regeneration. And it's sitting in the 10th house of profession. So Saturn is so strong, yet it's debilitated. A debilitated planet makes you work. An exalted planet makes you enjoy. Because in the past, you have already done that work. So now it's time for you to enjoy. In the past, you have not done something. So now it's debilitated in your chart. So if you work, you're compensating. This man worked like nobody. We do not have the time for me to go on and say about his nature. It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
I will see it sometimes.
Yes, please do. Please do. It's beautiful. So then we'll take up a story of... We'll take up guardians of the unprotected. Or one story that all of us have heard about Ashwini Kumars in our childhood, and that's of Ashwini Kumars and sage dadhichi. And all Indians have heard that in particular. In fact, they also now have it in the syllabus in the Hindi books. So, and Ashwini Kumars and sage dadhichi, so they are skilled surgeons. They wanted to learn a secret knowledge from sage dadhichi, but sage dadhichi told them that it was not possible because Indra had told him, sage dadhichi, while imparting that knowledge to him, that if you give this knowledge to anybody, that at that very moment, the moment you complete giving that knowledge, your head will burst and you will die. So these Kumaras come to sage dadhichi and say that, don't you worry. What we will do is we'll replace your head and your neck with that of a horse. You give us the instruction, we will understand. And once your head bursts, we'll replace it with your original head. So they are first and foremost very ace surgeons, very skilled surgeons. Like you said, your grandmother got operated and she was in very safe hands. Because probably the Ashwini Kumars came down to aid her operation. They have a thirst for knowledge. Okay. And so what happened was, this is exactly how it turned out. And the Ashwini Kumars got that knowledge. So there's a huge amount of thirst of knowledge with these people. They love to understand. They love to read. They love to gather knowledge. And they love to experiment. That is why they're born leaders. The Aries are born leaders because they move into areas where the others do not want to go. They love taking that risk.
Very true. This is.
Thank you. So especially the the ascendant, which falls in the 13 degree 20 minutes, first 13 degree 20 minutes belonging to the Ashwini Kumars. And you have the inventions, they go about doing a lot of inventions and they rub shoulders with the high and the mighty. They always on a path of self-improvement. Not very visible to others because it's a passive nakshatra, but always on a path of self-improvement. And they are very ambitious. They want to climb up. Like the ram, they want to climb to the, you know, the highest point, peak. So they want to move from the rats to the riches. So just one example before we move on to the remedial measures, okay? Thirst for knowledge. Nikola Tesla.
Perfect.
Everybody knows who he is. And the amount of work that he has done for, the amount of work that he has done for electricity in his generation, selflessly, the amount of work that he has done. Nobody else did it. He gave all of that he had, you know, his money, everything he put into his inventions. He was just so much into his inventions, knowledge and invention, that he didn't have much care about his own self.
Okay.
And we see that his lagna is in Ashwini. So I think that speaks for itself. They have... Muhammad Ali, highly ambitious.
Okay.
A retrograde seventh lord sitting debilitated and in the 10th house. When a planet is retrograde and debilitated, it works as an exalted planet. Uttara Kalamrita, a classical text, says so. Okay. And I have worked on this and I can vouch that it works like that.
Oh.
Except for some parts of Jupiter. Sometimes Jupiter does not work like that. But that's another day, another story. So, desire to rub shoulders with the high and mighty is something because they want to move into higher circles. And he has his 10th lord. Sorry. He has his Mars. Yes, he has his Mars. 10th lord sitting in the 10th house itself. With a debilitated 7th lord. Okay? And that's... So this Mars is also under Panch Mahapurusha Yoga.
Yes, yes.
Right. And so this Mars is very strong. Also, you need to know that in the 10th house, Mars becomes Digbali.
And it is also, I mean, it's very strong there in 10th house and it's also the 5th lord and I mean, it's all good here.
Yeah, it's a yoga karaka for this planet.
Yes.
For this lagna.
Yoga.
So all good things. And Mars is also about fighting. Mars is also about getting a lot of, energy, vigor. So with him, it was all about energy, vigor, fights, everything. Which put him onto a platform. Power, energy. Mars is... in a very good position, Mars is the general who has a lot of power. And one place we will also see